Hello friends, I am Adnan Tiwari and welcome to you all in Gatematic channel. So please subscribe our channel and click on bell icon for further updates. Okay, so we have covered some important topic in power transmission line and compensation method. So next part we will study is ABCD parameter of long transmission line. We have covered short transmission line and medium line. Now it is ABCD parameter of long transmission line. So in long transmission line, all parameters are present RLCG. Okay, this RLCG are distributed type. This is distributed uniformly across the length of the line. So if you see, this is RLCG. This type we arrange the transmission line, long transmission line. This all are distributed uniformly. So suppose this is our sending end side, this is receiving end side. We are receiving current as IR, we are sending current as IS, and total length is L. So suppose X equals to 0 is at receiving end side, X equals to L is at sending end side, and we are considering this part of length. Suppose this length is del X. Okay, this is R into del X, L into del X, C del X, and this is G del X. Why del X? Because these all are in parameter are distributed, that is this value is ohm per kilometer, that's why you need to multiply with this distance, you will get the resistance up to this part. Now suppose at this point the voltage is V of X. So this is voltage Vx. When we increase across the left hand side, the voltage is increased, suppose, and this voltage becomes Vx of delta X. Because distance is increasing x to delta x, that's why this point voltage is V of x plus delta x. So we have some boundary condition. We have boundary condition as at x equals to 0, V of x, we can write it as Vr, because at x equals to 0 this voltage is receiving end side voltage, and I of x is equals to I of R. And at X equals to length of the line, V of X is equals to Vs, I of X is equals to Is. So this is boundary condition. At X equals to 0, we are receiving end side, and X equals to L, the sending end side will come as part. Now we have some parameters. First parameter is propagation constant. Propagation constant. So propagation constant gamma is equals to square root of y into z, and we have characteristics equation. Characteristics equation as zc, that is equals to square root of z by y. So this propagation constant is defined as square root of yz. Y is the admittance of the line, z is the impedance of the line, and characteristics equation is zc is equal to square root of z by y. And z is the impedance of series line, that is r plus j omega l, and y equals to g plus j omega c, because this is admittance, that's why this is 1 by resistance and this is 1 by xc, so it will come as g plus j omega c. So these terms will we will use in the analysis of long transmission line. Okay, so for the analysis we have assumed the del x part of del x length of the line. So we have resistance here and this is inductance. So total resistance for the line length del x is R del x, and total inductance is L into dx, and C del x, and this is G del x, So total, this is the total inductance, that is total resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance. This side voltage we have x plus del x, and this is vx. So current we are sending I x of delta x, and this is current leaving entering here I of x. So this term we can convert it into total impedance of the line and total admittance of the line. So current entering here I x plus delta x, so this side current is I x and this current is I 1. This is voltage Vx plus delta x, this voltage is V of x. Okay, so now we'll analyze this circuit. Now if you apply KVL in this circuit, then V of x plus delta x, we can write it as Vx plus I of x into Z del x. If you apply KVL in this loop, that is Vx plus delta x equals to Z del x into Ix plus Vx. So this equation will come. Now we can write it as here Vx plus delta x minus of Vx and divided by del x. It will gives you I of x into Z. Okay, so this term Vx minus delta x, this term comes to left hand side and del x we divide here. So if you apply limit delta x tends to 0 on both sides, so this term represent the derivative of V with respect to x, and this will give you Z I x. So we will get one equation for voltage, that is equals to Z I x dV by dx is equals to Z I x. Now apply KCL at node A. If you apply KCL at node A, I of x plus delta x is equals to I of x plus I1, because this current is entering and these both current are leaving through the node. So I of x plus delta x minus I of x is equals to I1, and I1 we can write it as, see this side voltage is V of x plus delta x, and admittance is y delta x. So this is I1 because this voltage is V of x plus delta x and admittance is y del x. And now we are considering del x to the denominator, so it will comes as V of x plus delta x into y, because delta x we can take it as in the denominator. Now again apply limit del x tends to 0 on both sides, you will get this term as derivative of current with respect to distance, and we put here del x is 0, so it will comes as y into V of x. So we get the voltage derivative and current derivative equation. Now differentiate this term one more time, you will get del square V by del x square, that is equals to Z di by dx, and di by dx we can put here, you will get yz Vx. Okay, and we have no propagation constant is square root of ZY, that means it will gives you gamma square V of x. So we got the equation del square V by dx square equals to gamma square Vx. Now if you solve this equation, you will get an equation in terms of A1 e to the power gamma x plus A2 e to the power minus gamma x. So we will get the equation for voltage Vx. Now derivative, if you take derivative of this part dv by dx, you will get A1 e to the power gamma x into gamma minus A2 e to the power minus gamma x into gamma. That means we have del v by del x, dv by dx we have derived equation is Z into Ix. So dv by dx we have, so we can put it here Ix is equals to gamma is constant common in both the term, and Z we write it in the right hand side, so it will gives you A1 e to the power gamma x minus A2 e to the power minus gamma x. So you will get the equation for current, and we have voltage equation, and gamma is equals to square root of ZY, and gamma by Z is equals to by Z, that is equals to square root of y by z, we can write it as this, and square root of y by z is equals to 1 by zc, because zc we have square root of z by y. So it is clear, no? Why it is 1 by zc? So we are writing here ix equals to 1 by zc a1 e to the power gamma x minus a2 e to the power minus gamma x. So this is for current equation ix. Now we know boundary condition. At x equals to 0, vx equals to vr and ix equals to ir. So this is for the receiving side. Now if you put x equals to 0 in this equation and in this part, so if you put in this part, e to the power 0 is plus 1, e to the power minus 0 is plus 1, that means you will get a1 plus a2, that is equals to, and vx will come as vr. And again put this x equals to 0 in this equation, you will get a1 minus a2 is equals to ir, and this zc we are considering into multiplying with ir. So if you solve this equation, you will get a1 as vr plus ir zc by 2, and a2 you will get as vr minus ir zc by 2. So this both equation a1 and a2 will come here from this equation. Now this a1 a2 put in this equation, that is equals to vx equals to a1 is vr plus ir zc by 2 into e to the power gamma x, plus a2 is vr minus ir zc by 2 into e to the power minus gamma x. Now consider vr and ir separate term, then vr into e to the power gamma x, here vr is plus e to the power minus gamma x by 2, and again plus ir zc, if you take common, then it will give you e to the power gamma x minus e to the power minus gamma x by 2. Now if you solve this part, e to the power gamma x plus e to the power minus gamma x, you will get vr cos of hyperbolic gamma x, and this term is ir zc sine of hyperbolic gamma into x. So you will get equation for vx. Now consider boundary condition that at x equals to 0, vx is, sorry, at x equals to l, length of the line, vx is vs. That means in place of vx, we can write it as a vs is equals to vr cos of h, and x is equals to l, so gamma into l, plus ir zc sine of h into gamma l. So this will term gives you the a and b parameter, because we know vs equals to avr plus bir. So we have vs equals to avr plus bir, that means this term is a and this term is, we have b. So you will get the a and b parameter. Now we are calculate the c and d parameter. And when you put a1 and a2 value in this equation, you will get the current equation is. So now we are put value a1 and a2 value in this ix equation. So we have current equation ix equals to 1 by zc a1 e to the power gamma x minus a2 e to the power minus gamma x. Now consider 1 by zc, put a1 value, that is equals to vr plus ir zc by 2 e to the power gamma x, minus a2 value is vr minus ir zc by 2 e to the power minus gamma x. Now separate vr and ir term, then you will get vr by zc e to the power gamma x minus e to the power minus gamma x by 2 plus ir e to the power gamma x plus e to the power minus gamma x by 2. So this term will give you vr by zc into sine of hyperbolic gamma x plus ir cos of hyperbolic gamma x. So this term is for current equation ix. Now put at x equals to l, that is length of the line, I of x is equals to is sending end current. So you will get is is equals to vr by zc sine of hyperbolic gamma into l plus ir cos of hyperbolic gamma into l. So this is equation for is, and we know is in terms of abcd parameter is cvr plus dir. So in this equation, this part is for C and this part is D. Now if you consider ABCD parameter of long transmission line, so we will get cos of H gamma L ZC sine of H gamma L 1 by ZC sine of H gamma L and cos of H gamma L. So this is all ABCD parameter for long transmission line. Okay. Now we will design equivalent pi network of long line, because we are now dividing half admittance to the sending end side, half admittance to the receiving end side, that is looks like pi. So for medium line, for nominal pi network, that is medium line, we have ABCD parameter as 1 plus yz by 2 z y into 1 plus yz by 4 and 1 plus yz by 2. This is for medium line. And for long line, we have ABCD parameter as cos of h gamma l zc sine of hyperbolic gamma l 1 by zc sine of hyperbolic gamma l and cos of hyperbolic gamma into l. So this is for long line. Now we are designing the equivalent pi network of long line, that is it looks similar to the pi network for medium line. So this is pi network, this was z and this is j y by 2. So this is for the medium line, but now if you design the long transmission line in pi term, then what is the value of z and what is the value of y by t to in terms of long transmission line parameter. Now if you compare both the ABCD parameter, if you see z, you can write it as zc sin h gamma l. That means z is replaced by zc sin of h hyperbolic gamma l. Now we want the y by 2 parameter. So if you compare any a or a is equals to cos of h gamma l, that is 1 plus yz by 2 is equals to cos of hyperbolic gamma into l, that is y by 2 is equals to cos of hyperbolic gamma l minus 1 by z and cos of hyperbolic gamma l minus 1 and z we have calculated zc sine of hyperbolic gamma into l. Now if you break cos h gamma l into the sine form, that means we can write it at into sine square hyperbolic gamma l by 2 and this is minus 1, and this sine term we can convert it into 2 sine in theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, that is 2 zc sine hyperbolic gamma l by 2 into cos hyperbolic gamma l by 2. So this one cancel out, so we can write it as a 2 sine square hyperbolic gamma l by 2 by 2 zc sine of hyperbolic gamma l by 2 and cos of hyperbolic gamma l by 2. So this sine square and one sine will cancel out, 2 is cancel out. So one sine term is at the numerator and one cos term is the denominator. So this term will comes as y by 2 is equals to tan of hyperbolic gamma l by 2 by zc. This means this z term we can represent into zc sine of hyperbolic gamma l, and this y by 2 we can represent tan of hyperbolic gamma l by 2 by zc. So this time we can convert the equivalent pi network of long line. This is for medium line. By comparing with medium line, we can convert into the long line by putting these values. So we'll see one question related to this type, because one question is asked in gate. So we'll see that question. So the question is, for a 400 kilometer long transmission line, the series impedance is this. That means Z is given as J 0.5 ohm per kilometer, and the shunt admittance is, that means Y is given as J 5 micro moho per kilometer. The magnitude of the series impedance of the equivalent pi net circuit, that is equivalent pi circuit, that means they are asking for the long transmission line. The pi network means the series impedance in the long line of the transmission line is, that means we have Z and Y. Now we are representing long line into pi network, so we want, that is Zc sine of h hyperbolic gamma l. So we want to calculate Zc sine of hyperbolic gamma l, because this is the series network for the equivalent pi network. So first calculate gamma, that is equals to square root of yz. It will is equals to alpha plus j beta, and this is lossless line because resistance is conductance is zero and resistance is zero. That means it will gives 0 plus j beta, that is if you multiply 5 into 0.5 and then square root, it will gives you 0.6324. that means by comparing above term, beta is equals to 0.6324 and alpha equals to 0. And we have equation sine of hyperbolic gamma l, and now next term we want zc, that is zc is equals to square root of z by y, that is z is j 0.5, and this is j 5 into 10 to the power minus 6. So when you solve this part, you will get 316.28 ohm per kilometer. Okay, because we are calculating per kilometer basis, so this is also per kilometer basis. Now zc sine h gamma l, that is zc we have 316.28, sine of hyperbolic gamma we have alpha l plus j beta l. We are gamma is equals to alpha plus j beta, so we break this part, alpha plus j beta, that means 316.28 sine of hyperbolic alpha l into cos of beta l plus j cos of hyperbolic alpha l into sine of beta l. We are breaking this term, sin a plus b, that is sin a cos b, cos plus cos a cos b. Here alpha is the real part, so we are considering hyperbolic, but this is imaginary part, so all hyperbolic is cancelled out, so it will only cos of beta into l. So we have 316.28, alpha is 0, so sin hyperbolic is 0, this cos 0 is cos hyperbolic alpha is 0, so cos hyperbolic l is 1, so only we will get the that sine hyperbolic 0. Whatever this is, this term we can neglect because sine alpha is 0, that multiplies 0 with any term is 0. Cos of hyperbolic 0, and this is sine of beta l, so this will come as 316.28 into sine of beta l, that is 316.28 sine of beta l, that means sine beta we have 0.6324 and l is 400 kilometer, and this is in radian, so convert it into the pi, that is 180 by pi. So this value is calculated gamma into L. So this is alpha L j beta L, then it will come as 0.6324. That is, this value is directly we are calculated, that is beta into L, because beta will come as square root of z into y, that is 0.5 into 5 into 10 to the power minus 6. So when you calculated this value, it will gives you nearly 1.58 into 10 to the power minus 3. This is in radian per kilometer. When you multiply it directly 400 kilometer, then you will get 0.6324. So this value is directly beta into L, so there is no need to multiply again 400. Okay, so when you calculate this value, it will gives as 186.94. so answer for this question is 186.94. so the equivalent, the magnitude of series impedance is the 186.94. okay, and ZC, when you calculated Z square root of ZYY, so it is independent of line length, because it is Z is also on per kilometer basis and admittance is also on the basis of per kilometer. So per kilometer is cancelled out, so this is only ohm. Okay, so this is characteristics impedance is always independent of the length of the line. So it so in this part, the important part to break this part, sine of hyperbolic alpha L plus j beta L is sine of hyperbolic alpha L plus cos into cos of beta L, and then this term if you break, then you will get the answer as 186.94. so I hope you like this videos, so please subscribe our channel. So thank you very much.